I didn't think I would ever make this video, but this one is about Nathan. Nate. Wow. I feel dumb enough for changing his name. Because I've always never changed people's names if they're like a big deal to me. But, I don't know, something about this situation tells me that it's best to change his name. So, in the summer of 2015, I had to take a summer class at my community college. I had to take college algebra. There's this guy sitting next to me, and I swear he looked exactly like Connor Franta. And this was like right after Connor Franta came out, I believe. And I was like, no, but well, at least I found like a straight Connor Franta. Spoiler alert, guys, I found another one of him. Anyway, we were supposed to give each other our numbers to have study groups, and he texted me and he was like, here's my number, and I said thanks, and then he didn't stop texting me. We were mostly texting in class. And that's the funny part, is like we would be sitting next to each other and we'd be talking, texting in class. And within a couple of days I had stalked him a little bit, found his girlfriend, and I mentioned it, and he was just like, yeah, he played it cool. And so eventually I asked him, I was like, well, if you have a girlfriend, why are you talking to me? Because we were talking a lot, and I do mean a lot. And my boyfriend thought I was flirting with him, his girlfriend thought he was flirting with me, and he informed me, oof, I'm gonna fall off my bed. He informed me that his relationship with his girlfriend is good, but she doesn't share emotions. So he looks for friends that he can come to when he needs to talk. He was like, that's why I've been pursuing this, because I think you could be a good person to talk to. And I was like, okay. But it was really, to me, it's really weird to have friends and not hang out with them. Yes, I have a lot of those, but we were talking a lot. Like I said, we were sitting next to each other in class every day of summer, texting each other. So we went to Disneyland, because he loves Disneyland, I love Disneyland. So we went together, and it was fun, and he would kind of like hold his hands up behind his back. And the first time I like went to grab him and hold him, and he just like pulled him back super fast. I was like, oh, what? I was cringing, come on, like, guys, I was cringing so hard. But the second time he like had his hands up his back, and I like high-fived him, and I was like, oh, that's what I was supposed to do. And we went on Grizzly River Run, and his chin, or his forehead, hit my chin. I'm pretty sure it was his forehead. He's like a big forehead, hit my chin, because we like went down on the rapids and we just bonked. And it was so weird, like not being on a date, because it was like the reaction was so weird, because I was like he just hit me. And I don't know, that's just literally one thing that I remember about that evening. And the fact that he was like, oh, do you want to get chocolate? I'm like, yeah. And he like walks into Ghirardelli and he like just gets the free chocolate and just walks out. I'm like, oh. I mean, apparently it's a thing, but it's nothing I have ever done, so I was like, mm. And, a little while later, he was like, I just had a fight with my girlfriend. Like, are you busy? And I said, no. And he was like, well, can I talk to you? And I was like, yeah. I was like, come over. My mom and my stepdad aren't home. So he came over. He sat at my desk chair. And I sat on my bed. Ironically, not this room. And he told me everything. Like, he told me what was wrong. And I, myself, had never been in, like, an adult relationship. And I had no response. Like, I had no answers. I had no advice. And I was like, I'm so sorry, but I have nothing that could help you through this. And he left. And he told me later that he, that night, had went to his girlfriend's house, told his girlfriend that he had just been at my house and talking to me. She made him block me on everything. He made me block me on text, on just everything. So to me, after that night, he had just disappeared. Months, many months, many, many, many months, almost a year later, he like Instagram messaged me because he's like, oh, like, you're not getting my text, are you? He's like, I think you're still blocked. We talked, we made up, and it turns out he and his girlfriend had broken up, but he wasn't ready to, like, hang out with me. Like, he needed independence from everyone, and we didn't talk, and we didn't talk again. And then, next thing I know, I think it's been, like, over a year, I hear from him. A couple months later, I hear from him, and he has a new girlfriend, and he got with this new girlfriend like a month after he had broken up with first girlfriend that he had been together with for over 5 years. So I was like, well, I kind of thought you liked me, because when we were talking a lot, I would be like, oh, my boyfriend thinks I'm flirting with you, and he's like, my girlfriend thinks I'm flirting with you, and we agreed to stop. And I just told him, I was like, I need to know that it didn't mean nothing. And he said, it didn't, as in, it didn't mean nothing. So he was with this girl for like 2 years. We barely talked. Apparently, as he had told me later, every time we did talk, I would trash talk his girlfriend. Didn't mean to. Probably did, but didn't mean to. So he was with this girl for 2 years, and he had just broken up with her a couple months ago. And I was like, you know how I know? Because eventually he added me back on everything, but we didn't talk. And I was like, well, when are we gonna talk? And we had a couple conversations, but like I said, not really digging on his new girl. So, we just stopped again. And I was like, okay, I guess I gotta wait for this next girlfriend to be done. Because I was like, oh, she's a rebound. And like, a year later, almost 2 years later, I think, and I'm like, well, dang, that's a long rebound. But he was still following my sister, and my sister was still following him through everything. And I'm like, okay, well, if you're not gonna unfollow him, I'm gonna log into your Instagram so I can stalk him. About a month and a half ago, I just decided I was done. I was like, I'm done. He's not gonna talk to me, so I'm gonna talk to him. And I pretended to be my sister, and I Instagram messaged him. And I got a lot of answers. So, basically, my answers, he did like me, he liked me when he came to me for advice about his first girlfriend, but he thought I was acting disinterested and he thought I didn't care, as opposed to me, who's just like frightened and like, well, I've never had a serious relationship. And he took that as disinterest. And that's when he went to girlfriend number two. And every time apparently we talked about girlfriend number two, I was mean and negative and not supportive. I don't think that was every time, but I'm not ready to like go back and read everything. So, because of that, he just stopped liking me. And me, as my sister said, so you liked her, but because you made her crazy, you stopped. She said, yeah. And me, as my sister said, well, you should talk to her. He's like, I would, but it would be a very short conversation. And eventually I told him it was me. He's like, I thought it was you. And I was like, did you? He's like, it sounded like you. And I was like, well, how would you even know how I talk? So, he has another girlfriend now. A little after he broke up with this girlfriend of 2 years, I think almost three. I don't know, could be doing math wrong, but it was almost two or almost three. Pretty sure it was two for sure though. And he told me, as my sister, he was like, I think this could be the one. And I'm like, the one you're gonna marry? And he's like, it's too early for this. And I was like, it's too early in the relationship or it's too early in the day? Because it was like 11 a.m.-ish or whatever. He's like, both. So, he was like, I'm so sorry I did this to you, just forget about me. And I was like, I'm sorry, I'll never forget about you. And he's like, I hope you find someone who deserves you, who's better than me, because it's not me. And then he blocked my sister. And he unsent all of his Instagram messages. So I do still have the screenshots, but I don't want to go through them or anything. So that's where I'm at with this whole situation. And it's funny because on a day-to-day basis, like, I don't think about him. When I do, it kind of hits hard. Because, you know, just like passing ships and misread situations and not acting. And I told him, as my sister, I was like, well, if you liked her, you should have told her that instead of talking about your girlfriend and acting like it was about your girlfriend. I was like, if you liked her, you should have told her instead of... So, that's the story. And when people are like, no regrets, I'm like, I have one. Well, I think it's just one, but two. This is a big one, because it's so stupid. All right, it's really late, and this video is just a little longer than I wanted. So, I'll see you guys in my next one.